Anime Mad Libs. So, for those of you who didn't spend
Rat
your
Bat.
Sundays as a child at the Outback Steakhouse, Mad Libs are where you take a story and replace key words to make them funnier and a better story overall.
Like, as I've known Cole longer, I learned more about his childhood, and it's not like fucked up. It's just like weird. Yeah, you know how we're doing Mad Libs at the Outback Steakhouse? That's
Yeah,
where they
yeah,
have
that's a
how
thing.
we're doing what at where.
Yeah, it's
That's
like,
where you
you
went to
go
do
to
Mad Libs.
yeah, you go to church and you follow it up with a bloomin' onion and you do some Mad Libs.
We say the Lord's Prayer, we say a funny adjective, we eat a steak. It's great.
You get pumpernickel bread.
Great.
Guys ate oh, hate down pumpernickel bread now? Okay, I didn't realize it was this kind of stream.
I don't know what is
Oh wait,
that?
is that the kind of bread they have there? Is like the
Yeah.
darker bread? I've never known. Okay, thank you. I learned something today.
But you learned
Thank
about
you.
Rat Bat.
You learned about
I'm
Rat
trying to
Bat?
make it one thing I take away from this Mel
We have
is
to
pumpernickel bread, not Rat
offset. You have
Bat.
to learn about something evil and something good.
Yeah.
Balance.
Okay. So, luckily, I have my I just had my handy dandy Mad Libs machine installed yesterday. So, I
Is that why
think
you have to reinstall Windows?
yeah. It
It's
downloaded
also
a
a virus.
virus. Mad
Yeah.
Libs virus. So, and I haven't told you what these are, so you guys are gonna have to guess what these are after we're done. I just think that's a fun way to do this.
Okay.
Yeah, it's working so far.
All right, so are y'all
We've been
ready?
right every time. Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, so the first, Melanie, give me like a grouping, like a grouping designation, like team or like squad, like
Say
one of those kind of
team.
words.
Just fucking say team.
Eric, give me a title, like a professor or king. And
Okay.
Carrie, give me a positive adjective.
I'm saying squad because I like it better than team. Sorry, Carrie.
That's fair, that's fair.
I'm saying scientist.
I'm
Scientist?
saying thick with two C's.
Nice.
I misspelled scientist.
That's fine. I
As
just
long
want
as you
everyone
don't
out there to
misspell
know
thick.
when I give terrible answers because I'm bad at Mad Libs. I'm sorry.
I'm bad at the English language.
Same. I have to look everything up.
Yeah.
I have all these tabs.
I've been taking Japanese lessons, and she'd be like, "Oh, it's like this in English." I'm like, "What the fuck is that? What is that? That's a rule in English? Oh shit."
Give me a funny Eric, give me a funny celebrity. And Melanie, give me a funny name. Just
Like
a if
a
you heard this was somebody's
person
name, you'd laugh
name?
at them and point. First name, last name. Carrie, give me a
Dom
use
DeLuise.
Dom DeLuise.
Yep. Spell it.
I spelled it my way. And Carrie, give me a useless object.
Okay, I got. After Mel, I'm good.
I guess I'll do Harry Butts.
Nice.
That's
Hairy
very good.
butts with
That's
a
classic.
yeah.
My useless object is Rat Bat.
Callback. I like it.
It's all in the game.
It's all connected.
Give me a Eric, give me an event you would go to. Carrie or Melanie, give me an evil noun.
An evil noun.
Yeah. And Carrie, give me an unwanted trait.
Oh shit.
Okay. Oktoberfest.
Don't know why that made me laugh. It's totally a normal thing.
Does disease count? Because it's a thing?
Sure.
Okay. I guess that's evil.
I forgot what you
I
asked
don't
me.
know.
I guess that's evil.
I guess
An
disease is
unwanted
evil.
trait. An unwanted trait.
Fatty fat. Fatty fat boy. Fatty fat. Fat.
Okay.
Okay.
Eric, give me a type of industry, like entertainment or just like
Industry.
some kind of industry. And Melanie, something you wouldn't want to have happen to you.
Okay. Trucking.
The trucking industry. Okay.
I wouldn't want to die.
Good answer. Good answer.
Yeah.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Glad you love to hear it.
Yep.
All right. Let's see how this. I gotta do the calculations now. Okay.
I thought you had a program.
Yeah. It's him.
Yeah.
Yeah. He. It's okay. Actually it's Rapid.
No. Okay.
Here we go. The fate of humanity is at stake when two squads of scientists, the thick trucking bots and the fat diseaseicons, bring Oktoberfest to Earth. The scientists have the ability to change into different rat bats as they seek the key to ultimate power. Only a human youth, Harry Butts, played by Dom DeLuise, can save the world from total dying.
So, did we just call the Decepticons German?
Well, I mean,
because they brought. Well, yeah, I mean, we could always date this.
It's both of them. It's both of them bringing.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I mean, who can say, you know? But also, yeah.
Oh, yeah. We would never say it.
Right.
We'd spray it.
Yeah. Oh, I think there's something in your eye, Eric. Are you?
Yeah. Is
it? It's getting in the way of you saying yes.
Yeah.
I mean.
All right.
Yeah, so they're gonna weaponize Rat Bat against the Oktoberfest.
I fucking yeah. I lost the plot.
I lost the plot on that one. We're not good at Mad Libs, y'all.
It's okay. They only get better from here.
Okay.
Okay. They better
give me a year, Melanie. Give me a year.
1993.
Carrie, you give me a type of industry this time.
Mm.
And Eric, give me a creature not native to Texas.
I'm gonna go with crab fishing.
Good, very dangerous.
Yeah, it's my backup. Mm.
A creature not native to Texas.
Yeah.
Alaskan salmon.
Democrats.
Whoa!
No, I'm from here, so I am.
Melanie, give me a entertainment facility, somewhere you'd go to have a good time. Eric, give me a state, country, city, or planet.
Whoa, okay.
Say any fucking place ever.
Mm-hmm.
And Carrie, give me a number. Any number will do. It could be 69, could be 420.
Yeah, those are my first go-to.
It could be 68.
Oh, that's good. I love me. I'm going to go. One of the most quoted jokes that people liked, 419.
Nice.
Yeah.
419. Hell yeah.
I like 68 because it's like 69.
There was I don't talk about this very often, but there was like a 2 hour long period where I thought 96ing was like the same thing as 69ing.
That's so cool. Well, no, it's yeah, no, you're just but you're back to back.
And yeah, you're just like, yeah, you're just like banging the back of your head against their ass. But I was like in my head, I was like, no, it's just upside down. It's fine.
Yeah. You're like, no.
Yeah.
Hey Cole, I think my place is gonna be Berlin.
Topical.
Perfect. Mm-hmm. I know which one this is. It's gonna work mm-hmm. perfectly.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna say miniature golf.
That's very good.
Ooh. That's good.
I do enjoy a good miniature. I mean, not anymore.
Oh, you can watch hardcore mini golf if you're a first member.
Yeah.
See, mm-hmm. see what I did there?
That's good.
I'm in the first two episodes.
Why not the rest?
Because I kicked the ball.
Sometimes you threw it.
Because they told me that it's a two-day shoot, but if you lose, you can go home. And I went, well, I'll see you guys later.
Wait, that's all I got to do? All right, Mel, a cool adjective. Eric, a sad adjective. Carrie, a mode of transportation.
Cup.
Wow.
No, I'll do a Cybertruck. Cybertruck. Or does it need to be like more general, like car?
No, that Cybertruck works.
All right, cool.
Bleak?
Ooh.
Bleak, that works.
Damn, it's too real.
What's up? Dangerous, because no, cool. Danger is cool.
That's true.
All right, the calculations are running right now.
It just sounds like Rat Bat. Rat Bat's like running through the fucking. All I can think about is Rat Bat now. Like, what the fuck?
That's what happens. You put his cassette on, and it's just calculation noises.
I'm gonna be honest. I'm kind of turning around on Rat Bat. I think I kind of like Rat Bat now. I think I might like Rat Bat now.
Okay, I think we got a good one here. On the run in the year 1993, Alaskan salmon, the crab fishing bot, seeks refuge in a miniature golf place.
As you
in the small Berlin beach town. Berlin doesn't have any beaches. Charlie, on the brink of turning 419 years old, is trying to find her place in the world, soon discovers the dangerous and bleak Alaskan salmon. When Charlie revives him, she quickly learns that he is no ordinary Cybertruck.
This Alaskan salmon, I don't know. I don't think I threw the ball at the window and it didn't break. Yeah. Something special about this one.
This Alaskan salmon is 26 feet long and weighs 6 ton. Yeah, it's also a Cybertruck. Oh, cool.
Right. Cool. Cool.
Also, we could reference a couple things if we change Berlin to Normandy. We can make that work.
Nope. Berlin Beach Town. Nope.
All right, Berlin Beach Town. That's fine.
Mm-hmm. It's a man-made beach. They built it.
Yeah, no, it's a cup-made beach.
Don't they have that here?
Man-made beaches?
Isn't that a thing in Austin?
I think so.
There's they dammed off a river, kind of.
And then, like, there's, like, a big thing that, like, plunges up and down, and you can go, like, surfing in it.
That sounds like what extroverted people
do. Yeah, I was going to say, that sounds like something I would know if I went outside ever.
Austin surfing.
Yeah.
Well, Austin Surf Park.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. I had a friend who came here for RTX a few years ago who works at the Behemoth. And he was like, yeah, man, I'm going to go surfing. And it was weird because we both came from San Diego. So it was like.
So it makes sense.
Just don't.
It doesn't.
Just don't go surfing in Austin, Texas. And he's like, no, man, I gotta check it out. He said that he went and the water, it's because they just churn the water up and down to like make artificial waves. But it's just like in like this dammed off river or like lake or whatever. So all of the water is like brown and gross because it just keeps getting churned up from like the bottom. Oh, yeah. And he's like, so it was just like really murky. And I'm like, yeah, it sounds fucking terrible.
Yeah, this is why I stay inside.
So we should go.
Yeah. Derek, I don't think you realize that like the quarantine hasn't changed my life.
No, I mean that's not surprising to me. Really? Good. At all.
Yeah, I feel like you know me pretty well.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I get that. That tracks for me.
Yeah, you've seen me at enough uncomfortable industry parties.
Yeah, the only difference is that now you can't go out to dinner with friends. Sometimes you just have to order the food and then they bring it to you, which is just the rest of the times.
It's made it a lot easier to not have to make up excuses anymore.
Oh, it's so great.
I could just be like, Rona.
I'm dying. I miss people.
I just like...
You're saying I'm not enough, thing, Cole?
I miss going to bars, but that's kind of it. Like, the rest of it is like, don't go to work. Okay.
Yeah.
I miss doing... I miss like going to sporting events with friends, which I guess is kind of like the bar stuff.
That's true, but there's like no good sports in Austin, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah,
there's the baseball diamond, Round Rock.
Spoken like a true baseball fan.
No, but hey, you know what? I'm a fucking fan of there. Is they sell hot dogs where the bun is a grilled cheese? That's why I go.
Yeah. Hey, Carrie, did you know that there's baseball going on there right now?
Is it really?
Yeah,
capacity is open to 20%. You could go. Oh, no, he's going to go get a grilled cheese hot dog.
Oh, no.
You can go see a team called the Round Rock Hairy Men.
Is that that's real?
That's for 100%. They're 100%
the real name.
Yep.
The Round Rock Hairy Men.
The Round Rock Hairy Men.
I don't know.
All right.
It's awesome. It's like a Texas college league thing. I'll put a picture here. You could buy a hat.
They open it. Gross.
They open it to like 20%, and then you can go get like a grilled cheese hot dog or whatever.
I hate that.
It looks like Captain Caveman, but with like, but he's wearing a shirt or something.
That kind of looks like the hot dog I ate.
Oh, perfect. That works so well. All right, where's OBS? There. Huh.
It's gross. It's really important that you all see this.
You could so anyway, Carrie, I'm just saying that you could go to a baseball game still.
Yeah, anytime something like that comes up, I just think about having to explain to anybody that I care about why I got coronavirus.
Mm. I have to go see a Harry Man game to go get a grilled cheese hot dog.
Yeah, like that just doesn't have a good like mouth feel.
Yeah, I got you.
Yeah, like when I say it, Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, that's how I feel when I see people like eating at a Denny's right now. It's like
Denny's, really? Okay.
It's a fucking Denny's, dog.
Yeah.
Like, oh, we've been... Oh, wow, look at him. Look at the hairy man. Oh. I'm considering getting that hat because it is a Texas, like, minor... It's technically like a collegiate league, like, summer league thing. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like, hey, man, that's interesting. Maybe I want to get that. But then also it's ugly as hell.
It's so ugly.
Yeah, it's real so bad. Ugly.
It also does feel like a pretty uniquely Texas hat. Like...
I mean, he's carrying a baseball bat that's broken and a tattered Texas flag.
Why can't you just get the hat that he's wearing? That seems pretty normal.
It does, actually. God, they missed a fucking opportunity for that hat to be, like, for him to be wearing the hat that it is.
He's not even wearing his team's hat.
I kind of want this hat now, I'm going to be honest, though.
Well, you can drive up to Round Rock and go get it.
If they do curbside delivery for this hat, I'll get it.
All right. All right.
Oh boy.
Well, the calculator's finished, and we got a new we got a new one, hot and fresh.
Let's do it.
Eric, give me a popular group, like a boy band or something, like some kind of popular group.
Got it. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Mel, a well-liked and respected figure, like someone people all around just say nothing but the positive of. And Carrie, maybe I shouldn't ask you this one.
Uh-oh.
Good, ask.
A location you visit every day.
Go ahead, Carrie. You got plenty to choose from.
Oh, man. You know, if we could answer in order, that would be great.
Okay. I have my group.
All right, who's
my well-loved group is Mega 64.
Oh, I like this.
Mm-hmm.
A well-liked figure, Mel.
Keanu.
Nice.
That's who in all of our playtests.
Because he's a well-liked figure.
Every single time. Location you'd visit every day, Carrie.
Do y'all want like the real one or the funny one?
Give us the humor, baby.
The Bone Zone.
Nice!
Yeah!
What was the real one going to be?
Yeah, what was the real one?
No, that was the real one. Actually, I switched on y'all. Cool.
The funny one was bathroom.
Yeah, because like, that's where poops happen.
Whoa! Oh, he said the poop word. All right. Nita, Mel, give me a precious possession. Carrie, give me an action movie character. And Eric, a cartoon animal.
Is it a possession that I have or just in general?
No, just in general, like a possession that people usually find precious. It can be something that you have. Okay. Sure. If you want to,
because I mean, I have like an obvious answer.
Precious. Your mic?
Baby angel. No, there's a cat right
Razor,
next to it.
Razor Black Widow keyboard.
Yes. It's very special to me.
Wait, is it under that cat? Is it that blanket?
It's a Futaba mat.
Is that an IKEA desk?
Wait, it's on top of your cat.
Oh.
Those plants? Succulents?
She's like, what's happening?
Is it your mouse pad?
Yeah, it's a mouse pad. I said
Futaba?
It. Futaba?
Futaba. Mouse pad! Right down mouse pad!
Mouse pad. Okay, mouse pad.
Mine is, so it's the character from an action movie.
It could be the character, it could be the actor. Either way, it works.
I'll say Brian O'Connor.
What's he from?
That's Paul Walker's character in Fast and the Furious.
Jesus Hell yeah. Christ.
So he's a good character.
A cartoon animal, Eric. A cartoon animal.
Ace called out, he said that Mel is going to say a pet.
I saw Mel is going to see a pet, a cat emoji, and then someone just said cat.
Yep.
You fools. You should have known she loves her mouse pad way more.
I just want to point out that this is the first time I'm learning the name of a Fast and Furious character.
Oh, we should fix that.
Like, like everyone's just no. I mean, like I've seen the movies. It's just that like I go.
It doesn't matter.
And then
yeah.
and then Paul Walker met up with Vin Diesel, and they drove in the car to get Michelle Rodriguez.
You mean like, Brian O'Connor and Dominic Toretto? What's his name?
Toretto.
I don't know. His name is Vin Diesel.
Yeah, it's VD.
VD.
My cartoon animal, Ratbat.
Ratbat. Ratbat. You make an appearance every time. Oh, this is going to work so well. Okay, and I want you all to brainstorm on this one. An esteemed profession. Give me an esteemed profession. Somebody like, you're like, oh, here comes Big Britches.
The person in Asian restaurants that makes steamed dumplings.
That's close. I would say general manager of Rooster Teeth.
Ooh, that's very good.
Ooh, yeah.
The good thing about that is keeping our jobs.
All right. Is that what we're going with?
Well, you know,
unless Bill has a suggestion.
Oh,
I mean,
no, that's, I'm not going to go against that.
Let's just put it this way, Cole. That is our answer, unless we hear it and it's bad, and then it's the thing that Eric said.
No, I got you. I got you. All right.
Okay. That Cole and Eric said. Got it.
Thanks, man.
Or all of us.
Okay.
I wonder humans if Ratbat becomes the CEO of Rooster Teeth or whatever.
Humans are at war with Mega 64. And Keanu Reeves is gone. The key to saving the future lies buried in the Bone Zone. And the hidden mouse pad of Mega 64 on Earth. Now it's up to the unlikely alliance of inventor Brian O'Connor, Ratbat, an English lord, and the general manager of Rooster Teeth, who also cooks sometimes, to save the world.
That's the most accurate one so far.
That's a really good one.
That was a good one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
man.
Okay, we have got one more. We have one more.
Can't believe Ratbat would team up with Paul Walker and Paul Walker general and manager of Rooster Teeth
and an English lord.
Yeah,
yeah, that's crazy.
Nuts. Seems like buried the lead a little bit.
Yeah, no kidding.
I'm just liking Ratbat more and more, I'm gonna be honest.
Ratbat.
No.
Okay.
No.
Eric, give me a number.
Mm-hmm.
Do it.
Melanie, a food you typically think you eat for dinner, and carry a household appliance.
That I eat for dinner?
I mean, that people.
Or maybe normal people eat
so
for
like
dinner.
So, like, any food?
You don't eat pancakes for dinner. You don't need
excuse you.
Excuse your fucking self.
Okay, my number's 11,521.
11,521.
Really long time to write out just a few digits.
My household appliance is... an Instapot. Bringing it back.
Nice.
Bringing it back.
Oh, bring it back. Cosmos.
Yeah. I forgot his name already. Crump? That was the other one.
Crump!
Crump.
I'm going to say pho, because it's fun to say.
Nice.
Pho.
And I had it yesterday.
All right.
Did you have for dinner?
Like, it's going to be like... the king of the food that you mentioned. Get it? Because it'd be like fucking
like the restaurant off of
what do you mean? Yeah, like, there's a restaurant called fucking.
Like Ratbat's the king?
Yeah, Ratbat is the king.
He goes, haha, I'm king now.
Of fucking.
I'm fun now.
Eric, give me some
fun.
Give me some
I hate Ratbat.
Give me some famous siblings who aren't twins, Eric.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Carrie, something that's embarrassing that can happen to you as an adult. And Melanie, a pop group.
Okay. Maggie and Jake Gyllenhaal.
That's good.
That's actually the answer I was hoping for whenever I wrote that prompt.
How is that the answer? How are you hoping, like, well, hope somebody says Maggie and Jake Gyllenhaal?
You'll see. Oh, you'll see.
Why do they kiss?
How do I condense this answer?
Make it as long as you need to.
I can condense it for you. I can
accidentally walking to work without pants on.
Very relatable.
Mm-hmm. You know how you're always walking to work and you get to work and you go, my pants.
Where'd they go?
I'm Donald Ducking it.
I got just this shirt and it doesn't quite cover my belly, Winnie the Pooh style.
Also, my dick and balls are hanging out.
Right, Winnie the Pooh style.
Winnie the Pooh style.
Oh.
I guess I'm just going to say BTS.
BTS? Oh, yeah. BTS Army, okay.
Behind the scenes.
Do you ever think they put out a DVD that's like...
The BTS footage?
Yeah.
You ever think they put out
they didn't...
called ITS? In front of the scenes?
Oh. I thought that was like...
I thought you were saying IBS.
Yeah, I thought I was thinking like irritable something syndrome.
I'm like, what do they shit? Like, what do they do?
No.
I mean... Obviously, they shit.
No.
Oh, that's like they're perfect.
You can't. You've never seen them and shit in the same room. You can't prove that.
You can't prove it.
You're not wrong.
Okay. Melanie, give me a cartoon animal. And Eric and Carrie, brainstorm a Disney Channel star.
Oh, cool. Ryan Gosling. Justin Timberlake, Christina Aguilera.
What was that one show with even Stevens? Beans.
Beans? The guy who plays Beans. Yeah, I don't know his name.
I'm looking
You're not
going
to look
right
it
now.
Up. You're going to write
I'm
down
looking it up.
The I'm guy who plays Beans.
Okay,
don't
good.
Tell,
okay.
Don't tell him his name.
Yeah.
We want to write down the guy who plays Beans.
Okay, that's fair. I like it. Real quick, just as an update, on the Even Stevens fandom wiki page, Beans's full name, not the actor, don't worry, Beans's full name, we're still gonna go with just the guy that plays Beans, is Bernard Arangarin. His gender is male, his status is unknown, and his location is unknown.
What happened to Beans?
Somebody spilled the beans out of the can.
Oh no.
So Melanie, what are you thinking, like Jabberjaw or something?
Jabberjaw. What?
You don't know Jabberjaw?
I do not know Jabberjaw.
No, I don't know. Oh God. Oh.
You need to. You
Why
need
is that the first terrible. One?
You need to turn on HBO Max. It's where HBO meets so much more. You can watch Jabberjaw.
I'm gonna say Donald Duck.
Yeah,
that's a good one. That's
he's
good
on a
one.
Different. Yeah. He's on a different streaming service. So
I can do Daffy. I got no Donald Duck. Okay, this one's gonna be good.
There's supposed to be like a new Looney Tunes show on HBO Max. Is that good?
Yeah, there's. I haven't seen it, but I've heard good things about it.
I just watched the old Looney Tunes on HBO Max.
All right, boomer.
I mean, I watch a lot of old cartoons. Like, you ever watch Wacky Races?
Wacky Races.
Rooster Teeth should do Wacky Races.
We've been saying that for years, Eric.
I think you could get like different shows and different groups to do like there's a Good Morning from Hell and I Have Notes, Face Jam, like all like these different shows. See how I included your thing? And like there's all like these different shows and they all have like different cars. Like there's like a Hellmobile for Good Morning from Hell and a car covered in like post-it notes for I Have Notes.
I love it. I got so fucking
what I mean?
Many.
And like, and we do like a Wacky Races Cannonball Run style show. I think that would be really cool.
You heard it here first.
Mel,
folks.
Wacky Races is a show where they race, but they're cartoons and they try to win, but they sabotage each other.
It's got a dog.
Pretty, fun.
It's pretty wacky.
They go racing and it's pretty wacky. Yep.
Actually, they came out that dog has asthma, so we probably shouldn't joke about them anymore.
All right.
I'm just kidding. Right. I'm just kidding. The J.K. Rowling did and they just kept adding shit.
Oh.
No.
All right. Y'all ready? The calculations are in.
Let's do it. There's that cat.
11,521 years after he and his Fubot friends saved Earth from the Instapoticons, Sam Witwicky.
So much information came at us so fast!
Sam Witwicky, played by Maggie and Jake Gyllenhaal, faces a new battle. Walking to work without pants on.
What? That is a battle.
Meanwhile, Optimus Prime and the Fubots are currently working with the secret military organization, BTS, and trying to make a home for themselves on Earth. When an ancient Instapoticon known as the guy who plays beans from the Even Stevens rises to wreak havoc, Sam and his girlfriend, Donald Duck, or Daffy maybe, must figure out the history of the Transformers on Earth and find a way to defeat the guy who plays beans from the Even Stevens once and for all.
Wow.
So, beans! So someone should probably animate that, or I just, when the reveal of the guy who plays beans from Even Stevens happens, I mean, there's already so much just in the first part, but when that reveal happens, wow, that's something.
I can't wait to see the credits. It's like, actor's name credited as the guy from Even Stevens.
Yeah, the guy from Even Stevens.
The guy who plays beans from Even Stevens.
Sam Witwicky is Maggie and Jake Gyllenhaal.
Yeah, that's amazing. The way they do it is Maggie does the facial performance and Jake does the motion capture.
Oh, I thought it was just going to be they wear a really big trench coat and you have like Jake on Maggie's shoulders.
You're right,
or
I forgot. They changed the approach, but now they have the guy
trench coat technology.
The guy who's played Gollum, I forgot his name. I met
Andy
him
Serkis.
Once. Andy Serkis mocaps them.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I thought
he
it was going to be like a
two
full
people
house.
At once.
I thought it'd be like a full house where like they couldn't be in a scene too much, so they have to switch them out every once in a while.
No, it's a Fuller House situation where they're just not in it.
Yeah. It's a Fuller House situation where they should have just had their younger sister who's better in the Avengers play.
Could you imagine if like Elizabeth Olsen was just like, "Hi, it's me. I'm the daughter."
That would have been amazing, and she would have done a great job because she's great.
Mm-hmm. Because then they couldn't even make the joke like, wow, you look different. Because, no, she doesn't.
Not really.
Yeah, right.
Not really.
Yeah. Okay. You got it, dude.
That last story was very good.
Very good.
Yeah. That good one, I was excited. Save it the best for last.
We really ramped up there. Those were really something.
Yeah. I'm going to be honest. When I said Instapod, I was not expecting it to work as well as it did. But the fact that Instapodicons and the Fubots, like... Yep.
Okay. Natural enemies.
The natural.
Yeah.
Like cats and dogs, those two.
Yeah, one holds stew and one is good.
One is stew.
Yeah. So I'm very anti-stew.
Oh.
I'm anti-soup.
The only anti-soup. Good stew is the dad from fucking Rugrats.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Have you ever had that conversation? Cool. Everything's what? Either sandwich or super salad.
No.
It's like a pizza. It's either soup or salad. Which is it?
No.
What the fuck?
No, like I get the
salad.
Fucking... No.
So you're saying it's soup?
I mean, no. But I guess like salads can have croutons and...
It felt like Carrie was against like participating in this, but then somehow... He had no conviction whatsoever. You didn't even really have to provoke or back him in a corner. You just said, "So it's soup?" And he went,
it's not soup.
If you're not with me, you're against me.
Only Sith deals in absolutes, Cole. Don't even fucking get me started on that. I knew Andy for too long.
You think they'll keep making Star Wars movies?
As long as it makes some money, I think they will.
Yeah.
I mean, do you think they'll still call it like, do you think it'll be like another like trilogy, or do you think it'll just keep being the bad bitch or whatever their new show is?
I think it's going to be one-offs for a while.
Well, I think the movies is going to be Star Wars. This time Luke's here.
This time Luke's here.
Yeah, I think that's what the last three movies were.
Well, no, but now they're going to go remix.
Yeah. I've heard that they're actually thinking about like retconning, like going back and making a new trilogy.
Yeah.
What like, a waste, actually, this what is an what absolute happened. Waste of time.
Yeah.
We're done with Star Wars. It's fine. We can move on.
We're going to play Halo instead.
Yeah, no, we're not. I'm all about Dune now.
Should I? So Halo 2, I don't know. I started it. I'm like probably like an hour and a half into it. There's things I like better about it than Halo 1 for sure, which is a terrible game.
Definite improvement, but.
Should I continue playing Halo 2 if I'm not enjoying it that much? Should I play Halo 3?
Have you dual wielded yet?
No, it's been asking me if I want to, but it feels like I don't care.
Do you care about the story at all?
I couldn't tell you what it's about. Keith David is a lizard monster and he's getting zapped on a different planet. And they keep going, you are the arbiter, heretic. And I'm like, I don't know any of this. I don't understand any of this.
None of this means anything.
None.
I've got the novel renditions if you want to borrow those to catch up on it. Brush up on it.
Absolutely not.
They're really worn because I've read them all like 4 or 5 times.
Wow.
Yeah. It's really bad.
I would say either go to 3 or go to Reach.
Oh, Reach.
What's
is good.
Reach?
Halo Reach was like, was that do Bungie's play, last one?
Do yeah. I play as do I play as Mr. Chief or
you actually
do I play
don't? As that's like the thing about Reach.
Spartan. Oh. Right?
I think you should play Halo 3 and then play Halo ODST because ODST is like the best one.
ODST is fun.
Is ODST like a strategy game?
No, Halo, that's Halo Wars.
Oh, okay. ODST.
Do you like smooth jazz?
I mean
answering... this honestly. Do you like smooth jazz?
Yeah, answering honestly, yes.
You might like Halo ODST.
Really?
Yeah, it's all smooth jazz, baby. Yeah, I'm serious.
I was trying to figure out if you were saying there was smooth jazz in it, or
in it? Like,
there is.
Right?
Yeah, there is, and it plays like smooth jazz.
Yeah, okay, it goes down like a smooth,
like a John Coltrane,
guy person. Group.
I used to work at a smooth jazz radio station.
Really?
Oh, wow. Oh,
really? You may have, depending on the year, you may have accidentally played the Halo ODST theme without knowing it. It's very
when you
possible.
Were in there. Shoving the rat bats into the machine.
Like, it was just a bunch of cassette tapes, but they turn into bats and fly away.
Martin O'Donnell, let's throw it in there.
Okay, I'll play ODST. At least it sounds like something. It's got to be better than Halo 1 and 2.
Yes.
I would say so.
Yeah. Yikes. I have Game Pass, so I just got a bunch of games to play. I'm playing Banjo-Kazooie. That's fun.
Wait, Banjo-Kazooie's on there?
Yeah.
Yeah. I've only played the bad one.
Nuts and Bolts?
Nuts and Bolts? Oh. Yeah. Banjo-Kazooie 1 is fun because you can control the camera now in like this remake thing that they did. I mean, it's like the same game, but like now you can control the camera and you just collect Jinjos or whatever. It's great. I love it.
Here's the question, because you got Rare Replay. Have you played Jeff Force Gemini before? And do you agree that it's the best game of all time?
Is that a Sega game?
No, it was on the N64. Well, it might be. It was on the N64.
No, I've never played Jeff Force Gemini.
I've seen clips from it. I've never actually
It was Halo it, before Halo.
Wasn't that like a good. Robot?
Sounds
dog?
Terrible.
No, yeah, there was like a dog tank robot, and then you play as a guy and a girl, and there's like a bunch of ants that are aliens. That
oh,
blow
I know
up.
A game you're talking about.
Yeah,
I know.
That
no,
good.
I didn't play that.
This
no,
looks like a Mega
that.
Man.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, I could see that. Yeah.
Let me know when it's on Game Pass, and I'll check it out.
It's in the Rare Replay.
Is that on Game Pass?
I think so. I'm pretty sure.
I'll check it out.
Hey, Eric, it's on Game Pass.
I finally, I turned on my Xbox One for the first time in 4 years last week. So
there you go.
Maybe I'll get Games Pass.
I used to use mine just to watch YouTube.
That's why I'm using it.
Yeah.
Let me be clear.
My Xbox is lost to the downstairs cabinet.
Oh, mine too.
Yeah. Claim 2 Xboxes.
Yep. What the fuck?
I don't know why they put this place. In this chat, but somebody in the chat did say cummies or gummies, and I'm trying to figure out what they were referring to.
It's a game. Is pizza cummies or gummies?
No! The answer is yes.
I think it's gummies.
Well, thanks to Transformers for sponsoring this episode of Cole's Comedy Cavalcade.
Thanks Transformers, our own show. You did it. You're not sponsoring us, but we did it anyways.
When's
our Transformers
out,
show is
know?
Good.
Yeah.
And if is they have rat bat, I bet it's the best rat bat there's ever been.
Rat bat.
And same for Cup. No, and whatever the other
RC and Cosmos.
And Cosmic Encounters.
Yeah.
Do we know when that's supposed to be out? Have we announced that yet?
I don't know. I do know that there might be a San Diego Comic-Con panel that talks about it.
Ooh.
Oh my gosh.
That's why we had you on, Eric. You're a San Diego guy.
Yeah.
That's me, and I was here to talk about San Diego Comic-Con, apparently.
Yeah, we definitely haven't done the panel yet, and I talked about the great weather.
Live. Definitely not recorded 3 weeks ago.
I talked
July
about the
30th.
Great,
that comes up.
The great weather that was going on in San Diego and the beaches.
Mm-hmm.
It was great. Mm-hmm. Or it will be great.
Perfect.
Also. Comes out July 30th.
All right.
On Netflix.
There you go.
Can't wait.
And I would take this moment to specifically call out, you should watch Recorded by Arizal. It's really
yeah.
good.
Oh, hell
Speaking
yeah.
Speaking of series content you should watch, it's super fun. I'm excited to see, like, it's one of the rare cases where I haven't seen a lot of it, just because mm-hmm. it's, like, kind of a different branch of the animation department's working on it. Mm-hmm. And, it's
Instapoticons.
Really Instapoticons. Yeah, I'm a full bot myself.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, and if you like Issa, you can watch I Have Notes. That'll be the reason you watch I Have Notes.
There you go.
Or for Carrie. Nah,
that's fine. He's for Issa.
And isn't Justin Spears on there sometime?
Yeah. And then the there's like we have Stash Chan. Don't worry. Only hardcore I Have Notes members will get that.
Stash Chan?
Stash Chan, yeah.
Ooh.
It makes a lot of sense.
They got deep lore like Halo.
Yeah, we do.
Oh.
Yeah, smooth jazz and deep lore. I have.
Do you guys have? Do you guys have sprinting?
We'll see. We'll see.
I think that you could take one look at the cast of I Have Notes and know the answer to that one.
Yeah,
it's okay. I have memes for either. I have memes for either answer. Yeah. We're good.
We're gonna do whatever Halo Infinite doesn't do.
Yeah. If we're talking about San Diego Comic-Con, then the thing I want to say is check out twitch.tv/mega64podcast because today, Saturday, the 18th from noon Pacific, which is the only real time zone.
All right.
From noon Pacific until way later today, they're going to be giving you a Mega64 convention experience where they built the booth and they'll be streaming all day.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I'm going to go to awesome. That.
Yeah. Oh, so check that out.
Me miss conventions.
Yeah. So twitch.tv/mega64podcast, you guys can check that out. I'll stop in and say hey,
because my favorite thing about the Mega64 booth is going to it and then talking to everybody there and mm-hmm. them just ignoring all of the customers yeah. that are there to buy yeah. shirts just to like shoot the shit with me for a second.
Yep,
it's great. Yeah.
Yep, there you go. Well, you can have that booth experience for yourself at twitch.tv/mega64podcast today, starting at noon Pacific.
That's great. Melanie, what do you want to promote?
Watch Ruby because it's the only thing I do.
I'm out. No, thank you. I'm actually against that show now. So
we're gonna bring this up now.
I stopped watching after Forrest. I like.
Rip.
I'm a BFer. I'm a BFer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Before Forrest, and then
what does
once
the B
he's
stand
gone,
for? Oh, before. I see.
Yep.
It's like a Christ thing.
Yep.
Yeah.
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 I mean, yeah. Interesting, isn't it? Oh, huh. It's kind of a Christ thing.
Lord and Savior, one might say.
Yep.
All right.
You're assuming he's actually dead.
Are we getting Ruby? Ruby. Oh! Call the news!
The only way that he could be alive is like if the. I don't understand how he could not be dead. But.
Hey, it's
we'll see.
Cartoons.
He didn't fall in a volcano.
And that has spawned so many subreddit posts just by me saying that.
Yep.
It was 100% not a joke. We're 100% telling the whole truth and nothing but the truth. So help you God.
I've already finished my volume 8 recordings. Oh, was I not supposed to say that? Oh,
no. Just as long as you don't mention, as long as you don't mention your volume 9 recordings, we're okay.
No.
It's a good thing we stopped filming. Hey there, thanks for checking out the video. While you're here, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. Let us know what other kind of tier list you would want to see, what other shows, games, anything anime related at all. If you want to see more great content like that, head on over to roosterteeth.com. You can become a first member. We have a ton more to see.